Hello, hello everybody, hello Ogata. Thank you for this opportunity of asking an interview for me. I'm really sorry for my delay, but you know, the winter has finally gone and I am now able to have this interview for your YouTube channel. Well, it is quite interesting because I started postcrossing back in 2012 after I quit smoke, and I considered that I must do something with the money remain after quit smoking, and I start collecting stamps. But very, very fast, I realized that the stamps are quite expensive, so it was one step to postcards, and I search on Google and find the postcrossing site, and I found it amazing. I don't have any idea. I cannot remember. It's so long time, but pretty sure I'm that the first postcard was from Germany, because a lot of cards from Germany are traveling in this world, and a lot of German postcrossers are very, very active in the site. Well, very nice question. I just received this postcard. Is with an old lady near a post box. Is from Russia, and it was received on 2022 of February, quite soon. So this is the backside of the card. So beautiful stamps on it, and special postmark too. And also very, very interesting is the way that the lady who told me it is an official one. You can see here ID number. Okay, so you don't need to cover my address because it's a post box, so it's not something very, very private. And the lady write me an entire novel, as you can see, glued with some sticker. And it was so, so amazing how the lady found this possibility to write a so long story. And it's just great. And why is favorite? Because it shows something from the postal system. And I am a very big fan of postal system related postcards. Well, till pandemic time, the favorite part was postcrossing meetups. But after that, we can only join online postcrossing meetups. And regarding postcrossing purely, it is the extraction of address, because you never know what country you must send an address. And usually it's a big surprise when you receive an address from Ghana or from, I don't know, Macau. Even Cote d'Ivoire, or very, very exotic countries. I have here, I keep the postcards in big albums, and this one is already full of cards, as you can see, received. And this is a good idea to keep the postcards in albums. They are quite big and quite heavy, but I really have, I don't know, too many postcards in my collection. And also, a favorite part of the postcrossing meetups was the signing of the flag. This is a big flag with the postcrossing logo, and using it in photos. But the most interesting fact is that the flag, it's signed. Here was a meetup in Chisinau, the meetup with occasion of the postcrossing stamp from Moldova Republic. And I used to travel a lot. Here is in Amsterdam. You can see here the writing, Amsterdam in 7 December 2029. On 7 December is my birthday, and it was a very big and nice meetup in Amsterdam with over 50 people. It was really, really amazing. Well, the first fact was that I am a big fan of flags, as you can see behind me, a lot of textile flags. That one is the Moldova Republic, Romania, Holland, Iceland, Czech Republic, Russia, Netherlands. It's very similar with Russia and Germany, and also here. No, here is the Bulgaria one. So, and also Belarus, you can see behind me on this shoulder. And I received recently, I must share with you, a flag of India. It's made of so specific material. I understand from my friend who sent me, Finai Kukula is the name, that flags in India are made only from a specific material. So, and I wanted to have a flag on a postcard, the Romanian flag on a postcard, and I didn't find it. So I create one, this one, with specific information, the coat of arms, the map of the country, where is the country situated in the map of the world, how you say greetings from that country, the flag and some information about the country. And right after that, it was one step after to make other flags for other countries too. And after that, next step was maps of Romania. And those are quite informative postcards and educational, and people really, really like them. And right after that, it comes the Romanian postcard explorer, world explorer. As you can see here is the image of the postcard with the flag. Here is the national anthem. Here is Romanian currency. Romanian passport is like when you travel and you are ready to learn about some information about the country where you go. And most interesting is that here there is a QR code with the national anthem of the country. And till now we have like 22 or 23 countries with such postcards, PWE, with QR code for a national anthem. Of course, FOTV and MOTV are quite popular for the people. Also, I believe because they are offering the wide range of the countries, and you can find also so exotic countries like Tonga, Samoa, or I don't know what island, you name it, Nauru. And I believe that that's why they are quite popular in the shop. And recently, this year, because you ask, recently was launched this kind of design. Those are made by a Romanian church painter, and he is looking to pictures with national costumes, traditional costumes, and hand drawing, as you can see, a lot of details. This is a Russian costume, and I have here a lot of other examples, the original designs made by this guy. Here it's Hungarian. You can see a lot of details. And this is Moldova Republic. You can see the design. And here is, those are images not yet transformed into postcards, but they will come soon in the shop. This is Malaysia. And this is Indonesia. You can see this one is Singapore. Lot of details. I really like this kind of detailing. This is Norway. And this is Serbia. This is Ukraine. You see the flower in the forming a crown on the lady head. And this one is Bulgaria. And this one is Ireland. So the blouse on me that I am wearing, this kind of blouse is a Romanian traditional one. You can observe it in the postcard too. It's called IE. There are two letters, I and E. And you can find it also in famous fashion producers in this world. But this is a traditional Romanian blouse called Ie. Really, I want to develop new ideas. Always people ask for cats, for instance. And I recently started a new series with, just a second, I will show you. A new series of maps and cats. They are designed by an Italian book designer for kids, Svoni di Genovese is the name. She draw and write books for kids. And we started this collaboration, this is Finland map, with a lot of cats traveling and knowing things about that country. This is Romania. And you can see here a Dracula cat and the flag and some information, but they're really highly collectible. People like them. I thank you for the opportunity to speak to your audience, and stay safe, keep in touch, and maybe somewhere in the future we will meet in person. So good luck to you. Bye bye now.